in time. This is, again, trying to go out on the Comcast internet, and I don't know if this is making it or not because this is our second failure for the evening. It looks like something is working, but I'm not entirely too Okay, well, let's try it again. We'll see. That's take number 3. We may be live. We may not be. We're not entirely sure at this point. If anybody from Comcast is watching, we may have to have a couple of words with you about whether or not this should be working with a router that is less than 20 feet away. And if that's the case, we may have to find a way to improve the way this works. Hopefully this is going on. Not entirely certain. If I'm there, well, okay, that's great. Hopefully I'm here to bore you for another evening with a little bit more about weather. If everything is working, and there's no guarantee about that, gee, don't I sound positive. I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. If you are receiving me and listening to me and seeing me waggle my hands back and forth, it means that the two tin cans and a long string is actually working. I'm as surprised as you are. Now, onto other business at this time. Looking again at quiet conditions for right now, this is our triple threat broadcast, netcast, whatever you want to call it. We are live right now on Facebook, on Periscope, and also on Twitter. At least that's what I'm hoping anyway. Comcast could change its mind at any point in time, depending on whether or not the router has enough tinfoil on it. We'll have more details on your complete forecast coming up here in just a little bit. Drop your locations and your comments into the comment section below if you want to know more about the forecast. We'll talk about that in just a little bit. Love to know what the weather's like in your area. Yes, I know it's hot. Yes, I know it's humid. I was hoping for something a little bit more numbers, like if you have anything like the way of temperature reports from your backyard, put that thermometer to good use. Send us pictures. If you have anything you'd like to see out on our social media pages, drop it into the comments section or put them at austen.onek@wreg.com. Current forecast down here in the blue bar, where to find me on social media here, and back over there on the graphic. Thanks everybody for joining us. Alice McGowie, thanks for joining us for the update. Victoria Fondren from Sarah, Mississippi, thank you very much for joining us. Candy Tippett from Olive Branch, hey back to Jonna Mitchell, thanks for joining us. Jimmy Sue Langan, thanks a lot for the very nice compliments on there. Victoria Fondren, welcome to the show. And as of right now, if you're just tuning in, oh, good. And dot, dot, smile, representative, my wife, just checking in. Thank you very much from the next room. So I guess we know that the internet is working somewhere around here. If you are just joining us, again, things decently quiet for right now. Taking a look into and around the rest of the area, we're just not seeing too much of anything in the way of major amounts of concerns. All that stuff that you see around Memphis at this time, that's just the radar detecting, again, very copious amounts of both dust and humidity and birds and all kinds of other stuff. Shows up very easily at this time of the evening, and this is what we get again for the area that's kind of hazy out there for tonight, and going to continue to see again some fairly hazy conditions out across much of the Mid-South. Speaking of which, again, for the area, we're just not seeing a lot going on at this time. There were some scattered showers down around Boonville into around Tupelo, Mississippi, and as of right now, outside of a scattered shower in and around the Fulton area, we don't really have a lot of anything going on at this point, and probably not going to be seeing too much of anything really happening throughout the rest of the evening. Could be a few random thunderstorms from time to time, but that's really going to be about all that we wind up with for now. So outside of that, a little bit of a shower down toward the Aberdeen area as well, but beyond that, there's just really not much happening, and all that just outside the News Channel 3 viewing area. 91 degrees, Candy Tippett in Olive Branch. Thank you very much for the weather report from down around northern parts of Mississippi. Let's go ahead and take a look and see what's going on out there for tonight. We have, again, little, if anything, really going on in the way of major amounts of rainfall taking place. We do have, again, the scattered showers and some cloud cover out there. Decent sunsets out across the Mid-South. If you'd like to see more of these weatherbug cameras, go to WREG.com/webcams to take a look around the area. Ole Miss, a lot of clouds out there this evening. Likewise, St. Francis and Cordova. Heidelberg Elementary, City of Germantown, City Hall camera. A few clouds blocking out a little bit of sunset. And Windy Country Club just drove by there a little while ago on our quest for ice cream for tonight, And looking again at some beautiful conditions out there, a little bit on the warmer side, but again, much of what we're seeing is going to be that same way into the course of the next few days. Trying to keep you cool. Yes, I know it's summertime, so it would be nice to have a little bit cool conditions out there. From the United States Antarctic Program, from the National Science Foundation, the view from McMurdo Station, a live view from down around that area. You can see what's going on near the bottom of the planet from their live webcam there. Karen English, thank you very much for sharing the video. Very nice of you to do so. Here's what it looks like when it comes to temperatures down at McMurdo. Taken, this is about several hours old, unfortunately, but it gives you an idea as to what it looks like down there. A temperature of 2 degrees below zero on the Fahrenheit scale, 21 below zero on the wind chill side of things. Metrics over here, 19 and 30, the temperature and wind chill respectively. So that should cool you off a little bit as it's the midpoint of July, late July, and things are very quiet, but of course very chilly down toward the bottom of the planet. So we are getting at least a little bit of a chill out there. And if you'd like to know more about this or check out some of the other webcams or the weather from the South Pole, usap.gov, a very nice place to go to for more information there if you'd like to check out more details about some cooler conditions out there. Nowhere near the case here in the Mid-South area. We again have a heat advisory in effect for a good portion of the area, and we'll continue to see that throughout the course of the next couple of days. Again, the heat advisory posted for all the counties shaded in orange. That does include the Memphis metro area. A little bit more in the way of counties for Tennessee and northern Mississippi. Sherry Odom, welcome from Olive Branch. Thanks for joining us for tonight, and feel free to share our video around so everybody knows more about what's going on out there. Heat advisory means that, again, the heat index temperatures, that's the temperature and the humidity combined to get that feels like index, it's going to be about 105 to 109 degrees is what it's going to feel like outdoors. For all the cynical people watching tonight, yes, heat index is a real thing. You just can't wish it away. It actually works that way. That's part of what the National Weather Service measures. So for those of you who don't like that, well, I mean, it doesn't really help that way. There's not much we can do to change that, so sorry about that. We do have, again, some very dangerous conditions if you're working or exercising outdoors. What we have in the way of hope for some cooler weather is watching back toward the northwest of us as a series of cold fronts make their way down our direction. But what is going to happen as high pressure has been well in control? High pressure may just allow itself to work its way a little bit farther off down toward the east and off the east coast. Now, if that happens, we're going to be seeing more of this cold front coming through that you see up over around Kansas, Missouri, and up into the Great Plains states. As that makes its way into the Mid-South, by Thursday into Friday, Thursday night late into Friday, we could be looking at some stronger weather coming our way. Maybe even the possibility of some severe weather. We'll talk about that in a little bit. But the good news, along with the clouds and the rainfall, that's going to shelter us from a little bit more of the sunshine. And so that should help us by just a little bit with the temperatures over the next couple of days. At least that's the hope anyway. Let's take a look and see what's going on out there with temperatures. Again, into the course of the rest of the next couple of days, we just don't have too much of anything in the way of really good news here when it comes to the temperatures out there. Lows as we go into the rest of the evening tonight will be back into around the mid to upper 70s at best. High temperatures as we head toward Thursday, as you might guess, again into the mid to upper 90s, and that doesn't even begin to take into account the heat index. So again, if you're working or exercising outdoors, that's going to be a bit of a problem there. If you got pictures to share with us, weather pictures, things like that, again, don't forget about these social media networks. Drop them off there or send them here, or again, tweet them to me at aonic_WREG3, and don't forget to share our video around so other people can see what's going on. Thursday night, low temperatures back into the mid-70s, not much better than that anytime soon, but better chances of showers and thunderstorms coming up, and it looks like into overnight that threat will be spreading and getting a little bit larger as we get into around Friday. Then everybody sees that possibility of scattered showers and thunderstorms out there. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like huge chances at this time, but at least it is increasing anyway for much of the area, so something to take a look at there. And good news for Friday, the high temperatures will be on the warm side, back in the mid to upper 80s to right about 90 degrees, so that should help out by just a little bit. Low temperatures Friday night, back into the 70s, maybe a few mid to upper 60s back around areas close to Jackson and around the area up to around Dyersburg, Paris, Union City. Could see some fairly nice temperatures up there. Highs on Saturday, again, very warm, but not as blisteringly hot as they could be, back into the mid to upper 80s or so. So something we haven't seen there for quite some time. And chances of showers and thunderstorms pretty much gone from the forecast as we get into the weekend. So if you have any plans for outdoors, that looks okay. Very nice temperatures as we get into Saturday night. Mid to upper 60s out across much of the area. Haven't seen that for a while. High temperatures on Sunday. Also, again, quite pleasant, tolerable, back into the mid to upper 80s to right around 90 degrees. And chances of rainfall, pretty much goose eggs out there. So it looks like a pretty sunny weekend coming up. And let's just jump ahead to Monday and see what's going on as temperatures return to the upper 80s. Looks like a nice little stable pattern shaping up to where we don't have a lot going on and likewise don't have a huge amount of heat coming our way. So we'll kind of dial the thermostat back a little bit, but not going to be seeing too much of anything else to worry about there. On the Storm Prediction Center's page, we do have, again, some areas of severe weather possible, mainly just north of us tonight. St. Louis, Kansas City, Chicago, back to around Indianapolis, maybe a marginal threat of severe weather taking place, and that's going to be about the main thing to look at for there. Now, for around the area of tomorrow into around Thursday afternoon, we see again the possibility of more thunderstorms taking place. That marginal threat area starts to spread a little bit farther south, and it goes right about I-40 to the Tennessee-Mississippi state line. Anywhere in this area, we could be looking at the possibility of some thunderstorms that could have a very strong, possibly a little bit more powerful set of oomph to them. So we could be looking at the possibility of stronger thunderstorms here. Now, as we go from Thursday night into Friday, this is where things really get a little bit more interesting, as overnight that system seems to intensify for just a little bit. And as we head into around Friday morning and afterwards, it looks like we may see a slight risk category moving our way back off toward the east, but this needs to be monitored. If you're going to be doing anything outdoors over the next couple of days, you need to be watching what's going on with this system, and we'll continue to update this as we go throughout the course of the next couple of days. So pay attention to this, pay attention to News Channel 3, and we'll keep you updated on what may be happening out there. National Hurricane Center, again, little if anything going on. We do have one area, though, that just popped on the screen here not too long ago. So far, again, if you've been following these netcast that we have, again, it is something to take a look at in that we do have, again, a lot of dust out over the areas of the Atlantic, and that's helping to keep things, again, pretty quiet for right now. Now, looking out over this direction as we go into, hang on a second, the computer screen is trying to be cantankerous on me here. All right, well, if that's going to work, we're just going to do this the old-fashioned way. And there we go. What we've got is, again, an area down toward the air, close to right off of Africa, and it doesn't look like much right now, but what we're talking about here is a disturbance that just rolled off the coast. It looks like, again, it'll be not much of anything going on with this. About a 30% chance of this thing developing into something over the next couple of days. It doesn't look like much right now. And remember, there's a lot of dust between us and the area in and around Africa. So this could be something that develops a little bit later on. Could be absolutely nothing either. So that's something, again, we're going to need to watch with a lot of interest over the next several days. So please keep it tuned to News Channel 3, and we'll keep you updated on what's going on in the tropics. NASA could use your help as we go throughout the course of the next several weeks. We're coming very close to the total solar eclipse that's going to be heading our way. And it looks like that my website is once again crashing. I hope that means I'm still on the net. But this could be just a bit of a problem out there. If you have any plans for the eclipse, the basic idea, well, unfortunately, I guess we're not going to have this for right now. NASA wants you to monitor the weather where you are and become basically an eclipse scientist. Citizen science is a very neat thing to have around. Let me see, there it is. If you want to take a look at this, it's on my Twitter page for more information. NASA needs your help during the eclipse, and if you'd like to know more about how to become an eclipse scientist, it's a good opportunity for you to do so. You don't need a PhD to do science, and if you want to do things like observations, there are tons of scientists, research students, people like that, that could use your observations. The more people that participate, the more data there is, and the more we can all learn about our planet. It all works together for science. So this is something that you can do. And if you'd like to know more about it, head to my Twitter page, and it'll also be available on my Facebook page as well. If you'd like to know a little bit more about what to look for out there and find out a little bit more about what you can do for the environment, for weather research, for all that type of stuff, it's all available. But you already know about my Facebook page because hopefully you're already there. International Space Station will be flying overhead. It'll be right about another 15, 20 minutes or so. It'll be rising in the west just below the moon through that haze layer around the horizon and then heading up and around the northwest horizon between the North Star and the horizon and then heading over to the northwest horizon, or pardon me, northeast horizon, be between the W in Cassiopeia, the constellation, one of the circumpolar constellations that's very easily recognized, right up around the northeast horizon, and then fading away at about 9:38. This also has been posted to my Facebook page. If you'd like to know more about where to look for that, that's all available as well, so you can take a look and see on that. So that's about the brightest thing that we've got out there for tonight. But again, if you'd like to take a look at a good challenge right there. Now, if you'd like to know more about becoming an amateur radio operator, Captain Howard Thompson with the Germantown Fire Department and one of my mentors when it comes to amateur radio took his class for my general level license about a year or so ago at Germantown Station number 4 over on Forest Hill, Irene. New amateur radio class will be coming up in the course of the next several weeks. It'll be starting August 17th. It's a brand new technician class. That's the lowest class radio level you can get for newbies and beginners. This is where you want to go. Now, the course is free, but the textbook costs you $25, and it's well worth it. And there is also an FCC testing fee at the end of class for about 6 weeks or so for about $10. Very well worth it. Definitely worth it if you want to get you or your kids involved in the hobby of amateur radio. This is again a great opportunity to learn more, and this is also going to be posted on my Facebook page. If you'd like to know more about it, you can go to the Office of Preparedness from Shelby County, Tennessee, and that's at staysafeshelby.us. Again, that's one word right there, staysafeshelby.us. And then you can find out more about this and need to sign up for the class and or contact Captain Thompson if you'd like to know more about what's going on with this. Great opportunity to learn more, great classes, great way to learn stuff like this, and a good way to be prepared for things like severe weather or disaster communications. Being ready is a very good thing, and this is one way that you can do stuff like that. So please consider doing something like that. Becoming an amateur radio operator, it's more than just geeks tweaking around in basements with wires and antennas. It's a community of men, women, and kids around the world to help each other when there's big problems, and to be a community talking to each other when there's not. So something, a thing to think about at this point in time. Yeah, if you'd like to know more about this, again, you can contact Captain Thompson. He's on Twitter. You can also get him through the Germantown Fire Department, or again, staysafeshelby.us if you'd like to know more about what's going on here. Donna Kelsey Faulkner, again, about the eclipse. Definitely want to take a look and see what's going on there. NASA could use your help on that. Be glad to have you along for the ride. If you'd like to know more about the forecast early in the morning and you want to tune in because you're on the way to work or school or wherever you're going, tune me in on AM 730 Yahoo Sports Radio. Bob and Josh on Talkback Live Monday through Friday, 7 to 9 a.m. And definitely an opportunity to keep you updated as to what's going on. A great opportunity to learn more about sports chat in the Mid-South and all other types of topics. Talkback Live, Bob and Josh, 7 o'clock tomorrow morning on AM 730. That'll wrap it up for this edition of News Channel 3 Weather Overtime. Thanks to everybody for joining us for tonight. Billy Franklin from Lexington, thanks for joining us for tonight. We'll have another check of your forecast coming up tomorrow. Tonight on News Channel 3 at 10 as well with News Channel 3's Jim Jaggers, and of course bright and early tomorrow morning with News Channel 3's Todd Demers. Live and direct from Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Stay tuned for more on News Channel 3. Don't forget, email address right down here at the bottom of the screen. Be glad to hear from you to let us know what you think. If there's more you'd like to see on here, we'd love to know about that. And stay tuned for more with News Channel 3 on air and online. And thanks for joining us for tonight's quick edition of Weather Overtime.